Now, clearly, the financial circumstances of the league, like many of the smaller sports in Australia, like rugby union, swimming, they've been netball, they've all been struggling. And football faces the same sort of challenges. We've got great support from our partners, but the ambitious agenda that was set when the APL was first created, independent from the Football Association, launching into COVID, and there were mistakes. There were, you know, ambitions that just weren't able to be met in that set of circumstances. So what we're doing is working through all of that methodically. We're making changes centrally. We've had to let go a fair number of staff. We've had to resize the business, prioritize on football, concentrate on the league and the competition. And that means that there's going to be some tough decisions in the coming weeks that we have to talk with the clubs about to ensure their financial viability.
So that means about 500K to clubs as a maximum?
Look, the board hasn't met, hasn't made a decision about that. It's working through three or four issues that will all have a final effect on that sort of figure. But we're confident that with working with the clubs, we can find a way to keep everybody viable, keep the central APL viable, and continue to build on both the incredible work of the clubs coming off the back of the Women's World Cup, the growth in the women's game. You just had to be at the All-Stars match on Friday night in Melbourne between the Arsenal women, one of the world powers, and the All-Stars. Listen to the crowd. It was fabulous. Mm. So we had 78,000 people turn up for the Spurs-Newcastle match. You had 43,000 at the Marvel turn up at that match. So the grassroots support for football continues to be enormous. Our job is to work with the Football Australia. And the good news on that front is we, for the first time in many years, have a really constructive relationship with Football Australia, working hand in glove with them to rebuild the pyramid, to reconnect with the juniors, to reconnect with the base. So
we've got Gina Reinhardt for some money.
Good things. Yeah, we're working with them, talking to government.
No answer. Well, she helps other sports.
That's right. Just got to look at the amount of money the AFL and the NRL are constantly able to get out of government to see that football's probably not quite got its fair share over the years. But that's down to us. That's down to us not being good enough to sell our case, working with Football Australia to make sure that we keep creating the Matildas, keep creating the Socceroos. Now, every single Matilda played in the A-League. I mean, people forget that. Sam Kerr's at Chelsea now. Fantastic choice, Sam. World superstar. But, every single Matilda played in the A-League. Most of the Socceroos played through the A-League. So we need the A-League to be healthy to keep creating the Socceroos and the Matildas for the future. And that's my mission. That's the board's mission.
Okay. Well, I wish you success as always, Stephen. Thank you. Yeah, a bit different today. We'll talk to you again next week.